Hello friends, today we see here the practice set 5.1, problem number first of chapter quadrilateral. Now look at here, this is very simple problem. The problem is given us that the quadrilateral WXYZ is a parallelogram. This is parallelogram. And in this we have given angle XYZ is 135. This one angle XYZ is 35, and we have to measure here XWZ. This angle we have to measure here XWZ. So look at here, how is the measure? As we know, the opposite angles of parallelograms are congruent. That's why we can write it here angle XYZ. Angle XYZ is congruent with angle XWZ. XWZ. This is a property of parallelogram. Opposite angles of parallelogram. Okay, student. This property should be written in your question paper as well. But we know here. What is we know? But angle X, Y, Z. That is X, Y, Z. We have know here. And X, Y, Z is 135. That's why we can written as. Therefore, this will also angle XWZ will be equal to 135, and this is the first answer. Now, second question, if we know the OY is 5 cm, but when OY will form? When the two diagonals WY and diagonals XZ will intersect at point O, that time the OA will form as 5 cm, and we have to find here WY. So WY will be twice of AY because of this diagonal bisect each other. That's why OY is twice of WY. So diagonals of parallelogram bisects each other. That's why we can return here WO will be is equal to OY. But we know here OY is equal to length of OY is equal to 5 cm. That's why length of WY will be, this will be 5 cm. That time we can written as WY is equal to length of WO plus length of OY. This will be 5 cm plus 5 cm, and this is length of WY will be 10 cm, and this is the final answer. Thank you. Practice set 5.1, problem number second. Now look at here, we have given quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram again, and angle A is given in 3x plus 12 degree, and angle B is given 2x minus 32 degree. Then find value of x here. So what is the measures of x? Then find the remaining angles C and D. We have to also find here what is the angle of measures of angle C and what is the angle of measures of D. So look at here. As we know, the angle A and angle B both are the according to parallelogram property, these are the supplementary angles. So in parallelogram interior angles are adjacent angles are supplementary. So angle A plus angle B is equal. equal to 180. So what is A? That is 3x plus 12 plus 2x minus 32 is equal to 180. This 3x plus 2x, it is 5x, 32 plus 30, this is minus 20 is equal to 180. This minus 20 will go on that side and it's become plus 20. So it is equal to 200. 5x is equal to 200, that means x is equal to what? X is equal to 200 upon 5. So this is 5 on the 5 for the, that means 40. So the answer is x is equal to 40 degrees. Now we have to find here C. But C is opposite to A. That's why we have to find here A, and A will be equal to angle C. So what is A here? The A is, A we have given here 3x plus 12. 3x plus 12. This is 3 into x. What is x? 40 plus 12. So this is 120 plus 12, and it is 132. This is angle A, and therefore the angle A is congruent to angle C. That's why therefore angle C is also 132 degrees. You see, first C, and then remaining angle D you can measure here. So find angle D by measuring angle B. So solve this, it's on you.
Thank you.